Hey everyone, it's Zonflux here. It's another Quaze of Harland video that I'm going to be doing for you guys. The difference though is I'm going to be trying to show you the fastest way to do Quaze of Harland. So, ideally you would be in a group. I'm solo at the moment. But if you were in a group, this will be the fastest method. I have posted times under 11 minutes. From start to finish, as soon as you enter the instance, which is super incredibly fast. So, I'm going to get going here. And I'm going to try to do this as if I was in a group. Now, sometimes I do rely on champ stuns a little bit. So this group here, I'm just going to stun them initially, and then I'm going to start pulling these guys back a bit. I did get a stun here, but I'm not too concerned about that. I'm going to pull into this upcoming group here, and I'm going to use a Bring on the Pain just to help mitigate some of the incoming damage that I'm going to be receiving. I will be using a fair bit of power pots because I'm solo. Let's see what we got here. We have an archer, kind of high hit points. I want to get rid of him. So now that group's dead, I'm going to start heading up, and I want to try to stay ahead of the group here. I'm going to pull into this next room here. And I'm going to pull this group into the next room here. And then this group here, we just want to fight all together. I'm going to pop a Bring on the Pain just because I am a little bit concerned here. I'm also going to pop a Brutal Charge stun so that when I pop out of this, I can get a nice stun which will help my health a bit. This troll up here is stuck. I didn't realize that he can't get through. Usually if I'm running with champs or DPS, this troll is dead by then, but he is dead now. So I'm going to start focusing on this group again, and I believe everything is dead. So these guys will be breaking down these walls here. So now that Aragorn has made it, he'll be talking. And that's why we want to try to keep ahead of these guys. If you have DPS, they'll be able to kill down these guys a lot quicker than I was able to. I am running with a little bit more morale than I would solo usually. Now, if I was with a group with had like two DPSs, I'd actually run a little bit more morale. I actually go with about 40k morale just because the DPS groups that are going to be with me are going to probably have a better time at doing the burst DPS for the bigger hits of taking down these monsters. So I'm more just round them up and try to stay alive but contribute some DPS at the same time. Once again, you're probably going to want to try to keep on top of the power pots. That's a pretty big knockout. Now, if you were in a group, you'd probably be able to pull into this next group here. I am running a little bit precariously with my morale at the moment. But as soon as I pull into this next group, I should be okay. I had to pop a warrior's heart, but I should be okay still. I am having a little bit hard time because I am trying to do this as though I was in a group. I need to get some of these archers down at the back. Try to stay on top of your major poisons if you can. Once again, if you have DPSs in the group, they will be able to mow this stuff down a lot easier. I am solo, so once again, that is one of the issues that I'm having, is just the fact of trying to stay alive with the size of the pulls that I'm doing. Let's see. I'm gonna pull this guy into the next room here and get started with the trolls. I'm also gonna pop my strength duty bound. While I have this guy hovering, I'm gonna hit the H key to get the static tooltip up. I'm gonna get my brutal charge ready, and I'm gonna start this fight a little bit to the right here with my target on Barash at first. This fight here, the mobs are gonna go down really fast when you have DPS in your group. I got stunned. Ideally, I like to start off with a war chant and then just spread the debuffs. So I'm gonna wanna go back onto Call Mech, and I wanna focus my overwhelms on him. Trying to hold off on my Bring On The Pain as long as I can here. I will wanna take... Okay, 1 second, Trinity. I'm gonna have to take a small little temporary break. My health! Distraction! As I was saying, a small little break just to deal with my toddler. And then I'll continue the run here shortly thereafter. So because I am focusing on the boss should go down first with the rest of the mob dead soon after. Well, that was basically at the same time. So just give me a minute here, guys. I know I am trying to do a speed run, but I am a father also, so I apologize. I'll be right back.
Hey, Trinity. What you want, sweetie? Whipped cream? You want whipped cream? That's gonna cost you a hug and a kiss. And kiss, and double kiss, yay! And I want to kiss you too. Okay. All right.
Yeah,
Yeah, I'm just gonna put some whipped cream on the bowl for you, sweetie. Here. Take this. I still need to put the whipped cream away. Okay, good. Now we can close. There you go. Here you go, sweetie. Love you.
Okay, back onto the speed run, guys. So this part here, I know Gimli is probably going to be already waiting here. I hope not. Okay, so it's just starting. So I'm going to run. Now, normally you might actually just wait for these guys, but I'm going to run right past these guys, and I'm going to keep on running. These guys are still going to be dormant or not active, so they won't aggro on you. By the time you get to this next group over here, I believe you'll be able to aggro them. Pretty much. I might even be able to get a stagger on them. Yep. So I got a stagger, and I'm going to start running away. That's a short stun that I got, so I didn't bother removing it. Major poisons, I do want to remove those. And the idea here is I want to try to pull everything over to where Gimli is going to be. Now, my health is like dangerously low. I do understand that, but I will deal with it. So I got a bring on the pain, which is very important for this because I am going to need it. And if you have DPS in here, I mean, this is going to be crucial to staying alive. I might die here. I did die. If you had DPS in the group, you'd be able to do this though. So, I mean, solo, you wouldn't want to really do that solo, but with a group, it's definitely very feasible. Okay, so I am just going to be doing a stun here, get my stagger off, war chant. So I hope you get the general idea. I mean, I did die, but I was trying to demonstrate a strategy for you guys. It's a little bit hard to try to demonstrate the same strategy that I'm using with the DPS group. But, I mean, it works, and it's fast. Okay, so now this part here, I can actually start to move forward. And I'm going to be waiting over at this area right here. So since I died, I do want to refresh my buffs. This troll here, you don't actually need to attack it. I don't want to attack it. I attacked it. Oh well, I should have enough time to kill him anyway. It's not a huge deal. Okay, so it started already. Now, one of the things I wanted to talk to you about is while you're waiting here, the reason why we wait is because we don't want to go to where the Moomak is. If you go to where the Moomak spawns, and it's not there yet, and the quest changes, what's going to happen is the Moomak will activate before the archers have spawned, and then the archers are going to bug out after you kill the Moomak, and the archers just don't do anything. You can kill the Moomak, but the quest won't advance. And there's a problem in that because you won't be able to fight the Forsaken Reaver, and you also miss out on your chest. So make sure to wait before you go and fight the Moomak. Otherwise, you're going to be screwing up your time because you have to go and contact the GM to fix the issue. Or, you know, you'll have to go and pick up just reset it, which might be quicker for you. Kind of want to get rid of some of these archers. Let's see, are we good now? Is there any archers left? I think we're good. Now, like I said, if you're running with a really good DPS group, don't worry about having a really high physical mastery yourself. I would focus more on morale and just staying alive. So, I mean, that group that I pulled where I died, I mean, hey, maybe solo I could have stayed alive. It's hard to say. Ow. If I had a little bit more morale, but I also wanted to try to speed this up a little bit for you guys. So after you kill the Moomak, which is about to happen, just follow down the middle of this path. And as you're following down, you shouldn't activate anything. This other troll, if I'm going to activate this chest, I want to activate the chest on this side. And I shouldn't activate the troll. So now what I can do is I can just speedy Gonzalez. Can she get more with the cream, please, hun? Yes, thank you. I'm going to keep an eye on that troll. I don't really want to activate them. They do have a lot of morale. Certainly a high DPS character can kill them very quickly, but I cannot because I am a guardian and single target DPS sucks. I didn't kill him with that. Okay, and on to the Forsaken Reaver. With the high DPS group, don't even worry about AoE. Just do a build that has raw overpower in it. That's going to be your primary, and maybe even blind rage. The AoE can be dealt with by your DPS in the group. And they're probably going to be going, if it's champs, like redline for the single target DPS. This is a fairly straightforward fight. You don't even need morale for this, so if you have like kind of a glass cannon build for this, just go for it. You don't need any morale for this fight, at least on tier 1. We got our first spirit coming. I'm going to use him to transfer bleeds and then just transfer them back. There's one issue when you're doing this with other DPS is that those spirits just melt. You won't be able to keep the spirits up long enough. Did you give her more? Okay, mommy's getting you more. Now, if you had a DPS group, this guy would be long dead already. Almost dead. If I wasn't distracted, I probably would have traded more glass DPS for this battle. There we go, and good luck on your loot, guys. I personally believe this is the fastest way to do this instance. I definitely think it is possible to get 10 minutes or even maybe under 10 minutes, but it's definitely possible. The loot that I got, I know some of you like to see that stuff. I did get leggings of the rampart, so that's pretty sweet, and an endless starlit crystal. That middle chest, the Mumak chest, I have seen the leggings and the shoulders drop from that, just so you know. And yeah. Try it out with a group. I guarantee you, you're not going to be unhappy. This is one of the fastest ways that I have developed for doing this run. And yeah, good luck, guys. Hope you enjoyed.